Muchas gracias, hermano. Modelo especial para empezar. Buen provecho, amigas. ¿Qué tal está la papa?
Súper rico.
Súper
rico.
Un caldo de res, ¿no?
Sí. Que voy a compartir contigo para que lo pruebes.
Ah, bueno, muchísimas gracias. Tortillas.
Es un gusto compartir la comida con ustedes.
Totopos. Totopos, de ahí hay tortillas a mano.
Acá hay tortillas.
Arroz. El caldo lleva el arroz.
Verdura.
La verdura. Carne.
Elote.
Okay. I'm gonna have a sip of this beer first. Salud.
Salud.
Salud para salud para
salud.
Salud. Salud.
Salud.
Salud. Salud.
Muchas gracias por darnos estar acá. Gracias.
No, de nada.
This is darn good. I think I like it better than the regular Modelo.
This is the black one, the dark. And we are in one of the restaurants over here in Creole, a Pueblo Mágico. And we have a food blog, guys. So I'm gonna tell you what. This is what they ordered. She's gonna let me try a little bit. And I ordered this one here. In this region, you get this queso Menonita.
It is made by like some German or Polish Mexicans that settled here and well, they started making this cheese. So I'm gonna get to try that. It's gonna be a local cheese.
And I also went with the Raramuri plate. And what did you get?
I got some burritos and my own composition was mushroom, cheese, and champignon. No, how do you say? So I got some burritos with mushroom and cheese and some with fearless and cheese, like basic, but just more linger.
All right. Vamos a try, voy a probar la sopita esta de res. Entonces ahí le pusiste arroz.
Arroz, la carne, el elote, papa, calabacita.
Y le exprimo el
limón. Si te gusta el limón.
Sí, me encanta.
Y salsa si te gusta picar.
Y salsa de esta si le quiero poner un poquito
si
picante.
Si quieres picar.
Me gusta. Pero primero lo voy a probar así y después le pongo.
All right, guys, I'm going to do the most important thing that pops up in the comment section first.
And that is to remove the seeds. To remove all the amargura. All right.
We have the blood.
Está calientito, eh?
Sí.
All right. I'll just put it down here, like, get a better view.
¿Te lo comes así, sorbo?
Sí. Hasta. Sin cuchara.
Ajá.
Okay.
Para que, pero los que suelen esa piña.
Está caliente.
Sí.
Está calientito.
Okay.
Despacito.
Bastante sabor tiene el caldo. There's a very tasty broth, guys. Check it out, why it's so tasty. You have the piece of meat here with all this fat, and it gives it a lot of taste. La carne de res le da bastante sabor a este caldo.
I'm
gonna add some lime here to make it, to enhance the taste. They said it's better with the lime. Es mejor con el limón, ¿verdad?
Sí, si te gusta, sí.
Sí.
Y con chile, pues sí.
¿Y con chile también?
Pero pruébalo paso a paso para pasito que vayas paso. Agarrando el sabor.
Ok, so here we have some rice, calabaza. Let's give it a go.
¿Papa?
¿De
qué?
Mm.
¿Te lo pruebes tú también?
The lime enhances the taste. Definitely. Oh. Sophie won't try this one, it's not on the veg menu. But with the lime, it tastes better. It's the same effect that when you put a lime in a Corona, it enhances the taste. The same happens with this soup. Now next, el picantico. We have this one here. Le ponemos. Muchas gracias. Poquito nada más para empezar.
Okay. Para que pruebes. Y si te gusta, pues le ponemos.
Muchas gracias. All right, let's do this. Let's swirl it all around. All right. So when you swirl it all around, basically the broth gets the chili distributed everywhere. Ahora sí está mejor. Le da más sabor de picante.
Está cambiando el sabor, ¿no?
Ajá.
Va mejorando el sabor.
Mejorando poco a poco y se nota inmediatamente.
¿Ahora?
Tasty.
Ahora muere el elote.
El elote ahora.
Ajá.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
¿Sí?
Sí, sí. Sí, le pusimos un poquito. Está bueno. Sí. Mm. I love corn. Love, love, love corn. Here in Mexico, it could be maíz or they call this an elote. Mm. Good stuff, good stuff. Ahora la carne.
Uh-huh.
Ajá. Lo como todo en un pedazo y ya.
Sí, ya que está caliente.
Se derrita en la boca. It melts in your mouth. Excelente el caldo, muy sabroso.
¿Y te sabe diferente si lo tomas a sorbos?
¿Cómo?
O con cuchara? ¿Te sabe diferente si te lo tomas con cuchara o te lo tomas a sorbos?
Sí, no, con la así es mejor, cero contacto con el metal y
rico
y cambia el sabor. That's exactly right, guys. With the spoon, it's not that it loses flavor, but like this, you're gonna get more of it. Perfect like that. Mexican food vlogs are awesome. Guys, we're about to take a group picture. The whole restaurant is joining in. Everybody's joining in. All right. Estamos todos.
Tequila. No quiere. Listo.
Caguama.
Una, dos.
Whisky.
Gracias.
¿Amanecieron cruditos o cómo?
Sí, muertos.
Recansados de sueños.
Sí. I should let you guys know where we met. If you go on my, aquí cerquita, un hotel. Vamos a hacer a San Ignacio, hacer ese recorrido, sí. But we met on the train, guys. That's an epic vlog. Go check it out on Volpe. Where are you? I'll leave a link down. Hopefully, I hope I don't forget. But yeah, we met
there. We met this group and that group over there.
And, well, we just came here to check out the food scene, and we saw them again, and now we're just enjoying food together.
So almost like they're family, like we've known them for a long time.
That's Mexican culture. It's Latino culture, you know? You meet people after 5 minutes, your best friends, sharing a meal. It's lovely. Dos burritos, y aquí está el caldo. All right, guys, check that out.
What I wanted to?
Yeah, it's the soup with pechuga de pollo, garbanzos, aguacate, y queso menonita. Mm-hmm. Oh, y chile chipotle. Mm-hmm. Está bien.
I was a bit scared at first because it looks like meat, but no, finally it's just beans that are so mashed that it looks like meat. So, bigger than what I expected, so two big burritos.
That's what she said.
Basic, simple, efficient. Frijoles con queso. I got one with mushroom after. Pretty good.
All right. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and try the soup. Entonces, ¿seguro no quieren probar la sopa? Okay. All righty. Gonna try out this soup. What I'm most excited about, guys, is the queso menonita. Let's see if we can find it in here. Oh, okay, el queso está derretido en todo. Okay, check it out. That's the chicken there. You guys see the cheese is everywhere. We have onions, tomatoes, aguacate. All right. It looks like a completely different soup.
The chili.
Sí. Can't forget the chili.
Oh, también hay totopos.
Mmm.
Está muy interesante, sí, el queso ese. It has a distinct taste on trying to compare it to a cheese. Definitely, it's like the half cousin of mozzarella, or here like Chihuahua cheese, we can say it. A little bit similar to that. I mean, we're in Chihuahua right now. But it has a different texture. Again, maybe it's because I'm having it in the soup and it really melts right away.
Gracias.
But yeah, overall, yeah, the way it just melted, I liked it. Let me get a bite with the avocado and then we're gonna add the lime and chili to the soup. And we'll try that. Here we have a garbanzo. Mmm. Mm. Está bien buena. Pero le voy a agregar ahora el chile y el limón para darle más saborcito. No seeds. So the difference here with the soup, guys, is the chicken gives a lot less taste than the meat from earlier. So taste-wise, the caldo de res has more taste, in my opinion. It's just the juices, the way that the beef expresses itself inside of the soup is just tastier. Plus, you had all that fat there that we saw. Just give it a lot more taste. As opposed to the chicken, it's just, it's more shy in the taste department. Now, I have already tasted this chili and I like this, so I'm just gonna add like the whole thing there and voila. We're gonna give this a nice swirl. All right, now the soup has been chili up. We're gonna give that a go. Mmm. Sin limón y sin el chile, no es lo mismo. No es el mismo plato. Pero en mi opinión, el caldo de res tiene más sabor. Digo que es la carne de res, da más sabor a la sopa, la grasa que tiene esta carne suelta más sus sabores y se expresa más en la sopa. En cambio el pollo tiene menos sabor y por eso es un sabor más bajito, pues.
Aparte el elote también le da otro sabor.
Ah, también el elote, sí.
El elote, cilantro, o sea, son varios verduras que tiene el caldo.
Sí.
De res,
sí.
Que combinan muy rico.
Exacto. Sí, demasiado. Y también aquí hay aguacate, pero no se le nota la presencia mucho, o sea, es como más tímido.
Es que ese aguacate debe ser de Jalisco porque está medio claro, como tierno.
Y ustedes son de Michoacán, donde la tierra del aguacate.
She'll tell you guys.
Sí. La tierra del aguacate.
Y estuvo primer lugar a nivel mundial.
Berries.
Sí. Bueno, saludos para Michoacán, pues.
Sí. Que sigan produciendo aguacate.
Para todos,
todo el mundo.
Para todo
el mundo.
Se necesita el aguacate.
Sí. Completamente.
How's the, you tried the other burrito yet?
I just tried the mushroom cheeses, even way better. The mushroom are really, really good and it just give it a nicer taste. The frijoles are kind of, there's a lot in it, so it's kind of heavy to eat. But no, the mushroom and cheese is just more delicious.
Alrighty guys, I'm gonna finish my soup and then I have my main course coming in and actually I think it's not coming in. Alright, I'm gonna finish my soup and enjoy it. Pero nosotros le queremos pagar la cuenta a usted. Sí, por favor, sí.
No,
sí, sí, sí. No, no, sí,
no,
por favor, y no. Ya, está dicho, nosotros le encargamos la cuenta a usted. Muchísimas gracias. Nosotros la pagamos, por favor. No, 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 sí, por favor, por favor.
Bueno, ve las flores.
Oh, wow, ahora nací en la noche.
Muy grande. Esa es la entrada de mi casa y así está la fiesta.
So, en la noche se abre, inmediatamente, ¿sí? Baja el sol y se abren todas las flores.
Si un día quieren ir a visitar, como ahí nos esperamos con los dos años.
También. Bueno, ustedes ya nos vendieron el paquete para ir a Michoacán. So, de que vamos a ir un día, vamos a ir.
Me figura un sobrino. Como habla.
Tiene cara universal.
Se me
ayudó
a un sobrino,
¿no? De una. Oh, sí. Cara latina, pues. So, este es el plato de la casa, hermano.
Ajá. Wow. Wow. Mira eso, wow.
¿Qué rico
es esto?
En una concha.
Una concha con guacamole.
Una tortilla dorada.
Tortilla dorada.
Ajá.
Con una papa. ¿Qué queso? Hermano, ¿este es el queso nemonita o?
Menonita.
Ah, menonita. All right, guys, so we're gonna get to try the cheese without any altercations. Here we have la carne. Looks like we have some mushrooms there. Ah, mira, al fin como que sí tienen espinacas. Y que hay una pequeñita. They told Sophie they didn't have espinacas.
That's why he didn't want to give it to me. It's just a small piece for him.
Oh, man, okay. Bueno, tengo mi espinaca. Mira, hay queso aquí entre la carne. Sí, tiene champiñones aquí encima. Aquí hay más queso con... Uy, no, no, esto va a estar... Ahora sí le voy a pedir tortillas.
Perfecto. Ok, ahora sí podemos avanzar. Gracias, hermanos.
Muchísimas gracias. Bueno, nosotros dejamos que coman rico.
Ok, pues.
De nada. Solo menos.
Nos vemos más tarde, sí.
Ahorita pones un hola y ya se graba tu teléfono.
Ok, sí. Ok, perfecto.
Si no, podemos gritar: ¡Victoria!
¡Michoacán! ¿Dónde está Michoacán? Está bien, pues. Gracias. Hasta luego. Gracias. Alrighty, guys. Guys, I'm too excited about this plate over here.
This plate is just enormous.
This is what I wanted, you know. It's very hard to... There's an indigenous group of people here, and it's difficult to communicate. They're very closed in, so I wanted to try some of their food, but it might not be possible. But I'm very happy about this because I want to try this cheese, and now I have it over here. I think Sofonier is going to be able to try this papasada here.
It doesn't look melted enough for me, but maybe we'll try at the bottom.
You could try with the frijol, or maybe it's the same that you have.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
The same.
Yeah. It's a cheese made by German and I believe Polish people that settled here years ago. All right, let's just try real quick with the frijoles, and then I'm going to make a nice, delicious taco. That is good. And I can't wait to make a taco. So I'm gonna just try a piece of this meat really quick. That is good. Let's see how good it gets with this tomato onion sauce here. Yummy, yummy, yummy.
I don't know if they're gonna bring what I ordered, but I don't know anymore.
Oh, you ordered more food?
I ordered like a plate of vegetables.
Oh. We'll see.
I just hope they forgot.
We shall see.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Time to Mexicanize the situation even more. Hot tortillas. And I'm gonna have to cut a piece of this meat here. Alright. Put a nice little piece of meat there. And we're gonna add some of this papa asada. Look at that cheese, how that melts.
I like this part.
Oof. All right, so we got the right amount of potatoes there. Let's add some of this sauce that came here. It's more vegetables than anything. And some frijoles. Oof. And we're gonna try that just like that. And later I'll add some chili and we'll see what's up. Alrighty. Oh, my tortilla is breaking up. I don't like when that happens. Major thumbs up. Major. The tomato, little onion sauce all around is on the sweet side, so it's doing that. The cheese is very, very similar to a mozzarella, but even lighter. The texture is not as firm, if you can believe it or not. And the meat, well, the meat is delicious. This is the house plate. I approve.
I'm gonna try just in this corner. I see like a waterfall of cheese.
A waterfall of cheese.
A small waterfall, but still. I'm afraid I'm gonna take just all the cheese and not the potatoes. All of them. Extraction. Ending. All right, I got a potato and cheese on top. I like it, but still, I prefer chihuahua cheese. I'm like, 100% on it, no, chihuahua cheese cannot be beaten in front of.
It's more tasty, I think it's more greasy.
But still, better than the Oaxaca cheese, so I'll put chihuahua cheese, menonita, and Oaxaca, but chihuahua cheese will always stay on the top of my heart.
Here we have the tostada, guys. It's a crispy fried taco. They basically put guacamole on here. But I love the presentation of it. Mmm. That's some good guac. Definitely. The tortilla, right here, a bit stale, just a bit. It's not fresh, but I don't know how they prepare it. I don't know how often this plate gets ordered. But yeah, it doesn't ruin it. It's still good and tasty. The guacamole is delicious. But yeah, just a little stale on the chip there. I'm gonna spice it up and it should be even better. I've been finding out a new way to eat this food, guys. So I kind of just tear a piece of the tortilla off. And then I just come over here and I choose my target. Right now I'm going for this one because it has all that cheese there. And just eat it like that. Dip it in the sauce a little bit. Why not? Let those juices present themselves in there. Let's put some of this red chili there to enhance the taste a bit more. There we go. A gusto. And let's try it out. Chile on everything. The food goes up a level. You know when you play Super Mario and you eat the mushroom and it gets bigger? The same. You put the chili and you eat it, the taste levels get bigger. Here we have the bill, guys. So it's what you can expect to pay for what me and Sophie had, the two burritos, the soup, the hachera, and the beer is 515 pesos. So that is $25. $26 yeah. USD.
Yeah, knowing that I ate like regular portion and Carlos ate for three persons.
Hey, you know, I feel like I'm blessed to have this opportunity to travel and try all these delicious foods. And being the huge foodie that I am, it's, you know, I can't visit a destination and pass up the chance to try something that I might not get the chance to try again. So basically, I just go ham every time.
Yeah, I think it's really doing that for you. I'm sorry I cannot show as much, but I can just make a little burrito. But yeah, fortunately, I tried a lot more for you guys.
Alrighty, guys, these are the streets over here of Creel. Check it out. You have indigenous people that live in this area here. So the majority of the tourism is for the area around here and to see them and buy their handmade goods. Anyways, that'll be another video, guys. Yeah, I'm done here. The food here was good. I can vouch for it.
Yeah, I already had the ladies that you saw earlier. They gave me some bread in the train that I didn't vlog because it was earlier when we arrived. They gave me some like sweet bread with kind of a jam, like I think it was tamarind or something like that. That's why I could eat only two burritos.
Alrighty, guys, that's it, guys. Goodbye from Krill in Chihuahua, Mexico. Da ba da, da ba di, da ba da.